Now, Dr. Craig, it seems that you would allow for some measure of evolution, given that you've said that I've heard you give three kind of stages of human development, if you want to call it human development, of the development of those made in the image of God. There I can't remember what the first one was, but then it was Neanderthal and then Homo sapien.
Right.
So it seems that you would allow for some degree of evolution. But then the fact that you believe in a historical Adam and Eve would suggest to me that you believe the Genesis account, that they that they were directly created from by God, not sort of evolving from apes or something like that. Am I representing your view accurately?
Yes. I think that it's perfectly possible scientifically that Adam and Eve were de novo creations out of inanimate materials rather than out of pre-existing hominins. But given that we're dealing here with a mytho-history, I'm not at all confident that that's true. In fact, quite the opposite. I think that the creation of Eve out of Adam's rib is almost undeniably figurative language, rather than describing an actual surgery that took place with this rib floating in the air and then being formed into a woman. And even God's creating Adam out of dirt and then blowing into his nose, again, seems to be very, very anthropomorphic and figurative. So I think that the narratives of Genesis 1, given their genre, leave it open as to how God created Adam and Eve. And that makes it a scientific question. And when I look at the question scientifically, I think that the similarities that human beings exhibit genetically to chimpanzees, particularly broken genes that we and chimpanzees both seem to have inherited from a last common ancestors that has no function anymore, suggests that we do share an evolutionary origin with human beings, and that God used a pre-existing hominin who was non-human and merely animal, not in the image of God, as the stuff, as it were, out of which then he created the first human beings. And this probably involved some sort of regulatory genetic mutation induced by God in these hominins and the creation and infusion of a rational soul into them to make them truly human. So there would be both biological and spiritual renovations required in order to have a genuine human being.
Okay. And I want to so that sounds like theistic evolution. Is that is that a position that you're comfortable with?
I am comfortable with it biblically. I think that biblically you can't rule it out. The way in which it might differ from theistic evolution is the degree to which I want to appeal to miracles. Theistic evolution often tries to provide a purely naturalistic account of how God brought about biological complexity. Whereas what I'm suggesting is miraculous intervention on God's part to bring about a biological and spiritual renovation of this hominid form that would never have occurred naturalistically if left to its own devices.
Right. And to your point earlier, when you said it's improbable that you see that the removal of Adam's rib forms Eve, this is probably just language. You're not saying that God couldn't do that. I mean, you're saying that God can use some kind of, apologize, I'm not a scientist here, some early monkey ancestor and breathed life into this thing and allowed it to evolve. I mean, you believe
scientific.
Thank you. I appreciate that. But I mean, you believe that, God created the heavens and the earth. So God can do whatever he wants. He spit in some guy's eye and made him see. But you just see the language as suggesting that this is probably a little bit more mythological than it is impossible for God.
Okay. Exactly right, Josh. And I hope that our listeners who are young earth creationists today don't take the easy way out of accusing me of anti-supernaturalism and being against miracles, because that would be a gross misrepresentation about position. Of course God can do these things. My claim is that when you do a sensitive genre analysis of Genesis 1 to 11, it suggests that we're not dealing here with a straightforward historical narrative, but with a mytho-history.